do this thing.
I play Frankie Champagne.
Sergeant Sarah Brown.
Sky Masterson.
Adelaide.
We did a very fun spin on Guys and Dolls.
It's so good.
I love it. I absolutely love it. It's very us.
The dancing this year.
I absolutely love the dancing in this show.
It's better than it's ever been, I think.
Let's shoot crab. Guys and Dolls is a Broadway fable. It takes place in the 1950s. It was actually written in the 1930s. And it was written by a guy, based on a story by a guy named Damon Runyon. And he wrote these short stories, these sketches about people that he saw. He was a real people watcher and would create these storylines behind the different characters. And in this play, it's the story of a big roller, big high time roller, who is bet that he can't take a particular girl on a date to Havana. And the subplot is his buddy who bet him this is engaged to be married, engaged for 14 years to be married. So there's this double romance thing going on, and all these characters come into play to support and cause conflict in the show.
I'll know when my love comes along. I'll know then and there. I'll know at the sight of her face. How I care, how I care, how I care.
Sky Masterson. It's the highest roller of them all. It's a G. Falls in love with Sarah at the end of the play. And that's about it. He's the man, pretty much.
Sergeant Sarah Brown. She's very poised and thoughtful, and Jesus is her best friend. She's very strict. She's very strict, and she's very well put together, and she thinks she knows what she wants in life. She thinks she's got it all figured out.
A lot of work.
So much you can't even comprehend it. You don't understand how hard putting on a musical is unless you've been in one.
It's a lot of like showing up and a lot of more just being here, because if you're not here, no one else can do what they're supposed to be doing either.
Anyone in the play, everyone has to put in their all, because if they don't, then if one, even if you're a minor character and you mess up something, then it messes up, it can throw off the whole scene.
Everybody puts in a lot of work, so you can't, you know, knock somebody for not putting as much work in, or, because even the smallest parts, you know, you gotta know what's going on, you gotta stand on stage.
It's a lot of work, just like playing a sport.
I would say doing the musical versus sports is actually a little bit harder.
The other day, Mr. Mid was saying to me, I understand now why you start this process the end of November, because it takes so much. And it's interesting because we all think that we can learn it like that. And then, of course, it's a week away and everybody's coming together, and it's what I call the magic of theater. It just miraculously happens.
Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck if you've ever been a lady to begin with.
you're gonna ask me that?
That's actually pretty easy.
The dancing, the singing, listening to the lead roles, because the songs just get stuck in your head. I mean, I'll be singing them in the shower.
Oh my God.
Seeing students blossom and come alive and understand the power that they have in doing a show.
The whole thing, oh my God.
Probably at the end when it all comes together and like everyone knows what they're supposed to be doing and you can just watch it all come together and look amazing and yeah.
It's probably just getting to know people that you usually talk to. You know, you're so focused with your sports and your academics that you usually don't get out as much, and this is a group of everybody from all around the school, so it's just great to meet new people.
I think it's right before the show when everyone's backstage and we're all just so nervous and so excited, and we like get into that huddle and we start down and then we go up, and like just like all the nerves and all the adrenaline going, it's just crazy.
It was pretty special to finish that finale off and how we did it, so.
When you see a guy with the stars in the sky, you can bet that he's doing it for some dog. When you spot a John waiting out in the rain, chances are he's insane, it's only a John could be for a chain. When you meet a gent paying all kinds of rent for a flat that could fight the Taj Mahal, call it sad, call it funny, what is better than even money?
When you see a Joe saving half of his dough, you can bet they'll be making it for some dough. When a bum buys wine like a bum can't afford, it's a cinch that the bum is under the thumb of some little broad. When you meet a mug lately out at a jug, and he's still lifting platinum falderol, call it hell, call it heaven, it's a probable 12 to 7 that the guy's only doing it for some dough.
Do it.
You gotta go for it.
Just go for it.
Try it.
Now is the time to try new things. Now is the time to do something that you wouldn't normally do.
You have nothing to lose. If you're scared, it can help overcome your fears.
Stop being so scared. It's theater, it's fun, it's just do it.
I don't care if you're afraid. I don't care if you think people are gonna think you're stupid. Do it.
It's Hebron and it's fun.
The most magical thing ever.